Hello dear students, in the last class we have completed our chapter number 1, that is number system, and today we are going to start the chapter 2, that is polynomials. So let us start with the very basics of this chapter. Okay, this chapter is related to the algebra section of mathematics, and you know very well that in the algebra we deal with the variables. Okay, so in the mathematics, two types of quantities are there. The one is variables and the other one is constants. Okay, so variables and constants, when we talk about the variable, so we generally say when the value of a symbol in mathematics whose value is not fixed. Okay, what we say about variables, that a symbol in mathematics whose value is not fixed means it is changeable. Okay, and while solving the equations you see generally that sometimes the value of the variable is coming to, like if x is the variable, sometimes the value of x is coming to, sometimes it is coming 5. Okay, means it is not fixed. What is the value of x? It is not fixed. Or some other variable you can take, any literals. Okay, so that is the variable where the value is not fixed. Okay, but when we talk about the constant, so here value is fixed. Here value is fixed. How we generally use to denote the variables like x, y, z, etc. Okay, and constants, you know very well all the numeric values are there, like -1, 3, 7, whatever you can write. Okay, so many constant and so many variables are there. Okay, so simple concept is there, when the value of the symbol is not fixed, that will be variable, and when the value of the symbol is fixed, that will be the constant. Okay, now what will happen if we combine these variable and constant? Then it is called algebraic expression. Okay, so basically algebraic expression are what? It is the combination of variables and constants connected with the operators, okay, and what operators are there, like the sign of addition, the sign of subtraction, the sign of multiplication, or you can see the sign of division. Okay, so algebraic expression is what? Combination of variable and constant connected with the operators. Okay, and the operators can be either some operators will be there, or in an algebraic expression all operators should be there. Okay, means it is not necessary that only one operator should be there, only two operators should be there. Okay, means either there will be some operators or there will be all operators in one expression can be there. For example, 2x plus 3, it is what? It is the combination of variable and constant connected with addition sign. So this will be what? This will be an algebraic expression. Okay, some more examples we can take. Many examples, like if we write y square plus 3x minus 5. This is also an algebraic expression. Variable constants are there, variable and constants are there, and connected with addition sign, subtraction sign. So these are the examples. This can be the example of algebraic expression. Now from these algebraic expression, term can be defined. Terms can be defined by these algebraic expression. How we can define term? So we can say that the parts of this algebraic expression which are separated by operators, okay, like 2x plus 3 is there. So when we talk about the part of this algebraic expression, like 2x is the part of this algebraic expression, 3 is the part of this algebraic expression. So when we separate that, okay, when we see the separation of algebraic expression, okay, the parts of algebraic expression, then these are the known as what? Terms. Okay. So here I am only writing that parts of algebraic expression. Parts of algebraic expressions. Okay. So this is how terms can be defined. So firstly, whatever it is written on the board, you can note it down, and then we will see that what are the polynomials, okay, how we can define the polynomials. Note it down. Now what we say about polynomials? So we say that an algebraic expression, okay, an algebraic expression, an algebraic expression in which the power of variable, the power of variable is non-negative integer. Non-negative integer. And the coefficients of variable, and the coefficients of variable should be real number, and the coefficients of variable should be real number. So this is how a polynomial can be defined. What we say? We say that an algebraic expression in which the power of variable should be non-negative integer. Okay, this word is very very important. Non-negative integer. So when we say that it is non-negative integer, and also the coefficients of variable should be a real number. Okay. So these are the two words which are very very important for the definition of polynomials. Firstly, let us talk about non-negative integer. Okay. So integers are what? In the first chapter, you have studied about integers, that in the collection of integers, there are the numbers like 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on till infinity, and minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 and so on till negative infinity. But if I am saying that non-negative integers should be there, non-negative integers means these negative numbers will not be there. Non-negative. Okay, and 0 is what? 0 is no neutral, it is neither positive nor negative. Okay, so the power of variables should be only the numbers like this, that 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on in the polynomial. The power of the variable should be like this. Okay, in one word we can say that the power of variable should be whole number. You can And non-negative integers means what? Non-negative integers mean we can say that it is a whole number. So power of the variable should be whole number, and the coefficients. What are the coefficients? So see, if I am writing 2x square, then the coefficient of x square will be what? 2. Okay, if I am writing 5y, then the coefficient of y is what? 5. Means the number which is the constant which is multiplied by this. Okay, so if I am writing 3x plus 5, so if I am asking that what is the coefficient of x, so you will see that it is 3. Okay, so these are the coefficients, and these coefficients should be real number. Okay, real numbers are what? When I was teaching you, when I was telling you the flow chart of whole number system, then I told you that numbers are divided broadly, it is divided into two parts, real numbers and imaginary numbers. Okay, so all the numbers which can be shown on the number line, that are the real numbers, and imaginary numbers are what? The numbers which are negative in the square root, like this. Okay, the numbers which are negative in the square root. Only this type of number should not be here in the coefficient, that negative in the square root. Okay, otherwise each number can be there. Okay, so real number means all that numbers that you have studied which can be shown on the number line. Okay, so these are the condition of polynomials. Now let us see the examples of polynomials, how we can get the example of polynomial. So see, if I am writing that 2x square plus 3x minus 5, this can be the example of polynomial. Okay, is it following the two criteria which are there in the definition of polynomial? The first criteria is what? The power of variable should be non-negative integer. So here the power of variable is what? 2. Here the power of variable is what? 1. Okay. So they are the integers, they are non-negative integers, or you can say they are the whole numbers. So first criteria is fulfilled. Now let us talk about the second criteria. Second criteria is what? The coefficient of the variable should be real number. So you can see that here it is x square, its coefficient is also real number, its coefficient is also real number. It means it is a polynomial. Okay. Let us talk about another example. If I am writing that 2x plus 3y square plus 6, okay, is it the example of a polynomial? Yes, it is the example of polynomial. If I am writing like this also, that 3 by 5, then also it is the example of polynomials. Only two criteria are there. Power should be non-negative integer, powers should be non-negative integers, and the coefficients should be a real number. So here you can see that the coefficients are 2 and 3 by 5, both are the real numbers. It means that they are the examples of polynomials. If the number is written like this, that 5x to the power 1 by 2 plus 3x square plus 5. So is it the example of polynomial? Can it be the example of polynomial? Just think about it. Then you will see that the power of variable which is here, that is 1 by 2. Okay? And 1 by 2 is not a non-negative integer. Means it is not integer also. Okay. So 1 by 2, it is not integer. So this cannot be the example of polynomial. So this is not the example of polynomial. If the number is written like this, that 5x cube plus under root x square plus 3, is it the example of polynomial? What you will say? Is it the example of polynomial or not?
So here you can see that under root, and in that under root there is a square root, there is x square. Okay, and you know very well that whenever there is a square and the square root, then the square and the square root will be the cancel out, and the simplified of this can be plus minus x plus 9. Means either there will be plus or there will be minus. Okay, so this can be the example of polynomial. Okay, so firstly, if it is asked that whether the given question is polynomial or not, so you have to think about these two points very carefully. The first one is power of variable is non-negative integer or not, and the second one is the coefficient are real number or not. Okay, so note it down. Now the next topic is types of polynomials. Okay, so we have to see that in how many parts the polynomials are divided. Okay, but on the basis of what it is divided. Okay, so that we have to understand. So types of polynomial, it is divided on the basis of two major points. And that is what? On the basis of terms, and on the basis of degree. Okay. What are the degree of this polynomial? What are the degree of polynomial? ठीक है, पहले हम इसको समझ लेते हैं दैट व्हाट इज द डिग्री ऑफ पॉलिनोमियल. सो इफ आई विल टेक एन एग्जांपल ऑफ पॉलिनोमियल लाइक 5x क्यूब प्लस 3x स्क्वायर प्लस 7x प्लस 5 लाइक दिस, व्हाटएवर देयर इज द हाईएस्ट पावर ऑफ पॉलिनोमियल दैट विल बी नोन एज the degree of the polynomial. What I am saying, the highest power, you can note it down also. Okay, one more point you should write down, that the highest power of the variable is known as degree of polynomial. Okay, the highest power of the variable is known as the degree of polynomial. Okay, like if it is written like 7x square plus 3x to the power 5 plus 5x plus 4, then 5 is the highest power of this polynomial, then the degree of this polynomial will be known as what? 5. Okay, note down this definition and this example. The degree of this polynomial will be what? 5. Only you have to see that which one is the highest power. That will be the degree. And one more thing, the method to write a polynomial, that it should be written in the decreasing order of its power. Okay, means it is not the proper method of writing this polynomial. The proper method will be what? The proper method will be, firstly we will write with the power 5, then it is 7x square, then it is 5x, and then it is 4. Means the powers should be in the decreasing order. Okay, the terms should be written like that, the power should be in the decreasing order. Okay. Now let us talk about the categorization of polynomials. So for the first one is on the basis of terms, and the second one is on the basis of degree. Okay, let us talk about on the basis of terms. So when there is only one term in the polynomial, okay, when there is only one term in the polynomial, this type of polynomial is called as monomial. Okay, you have studied these type in your previous classes also. I am just reminding you here. If there is two terms, then it is known as binomial.
binomial. Okay, if there are three terms, then it is known as trinomial. Trinomial. Okay, then four terms tetranomial, five terms pentanomial, hexanomial. Okay, as you see in the chemistry also that you can study. But generally, we see after this T3 is trinomial, T4 is when the number of terms are four, then it is known as tetranomial. Okay, but generally we say that after this, whatever the terms are there, we call as polynomials. Okay, polynomials. Then the next categorization is on the basis of degree. So when the degree of the polynomial, let us start with 0. Is it possible that that any polynomial is having its degree 0? Yes, it is possible. Okay, how it is possible? See, firstly let us see that what it is called. It is called as constant polynomial. Constant polynomial. Okay. For example, if the only 3 is written, then this is the example of a polynomial which is having degree as 0. Why? Is there any variable you can see? No variable you can see, but here is the variable, and variable with the power 0. And I have told you in the chapter 1 that if the number is having its power as 0, then its value will be 1. And 3x to the power 0 means 1. 1 into 3, then you will get that 3. Okay, so these type of is called as constant polynomial when its degree is 0. When degree is 1, then it is called as linear polynomial. Linear polynomial. When degree is 2, it is called as quadratic polynomial. It is called as quadratic polynomial. Okay. When degree is 3, it is called as cubic polynomial. Cubic polynomial. And when degree is 4, then it is called as biquadratic polynomial. Biquadratic polynomial. Okay? So like this, the categorization of polynomials are there. Let us see one example and then we sum up this topic. Monomial, when the only one term is there, the example we can take like one term only, like you can take 2x². If there are two terms, many examples you can take. So I am giving just binomial. So binomial, if there are two terms like 2x² plus 5, okay, you can take any example from your side. Term 3 are there, like 3x plus 5 plus 5x plus 6. Okay, with the negative sign also you can take the examples. And polynomials you know very well. Okay, here the examples I have given. In the first part, if degree is 1, linear polynomial, then what example you can see? At 5x plus 3. Okay, the power of the variable is what? Maximum power of the variable is 1. This can be the example. Quadratic polynomial. Quadratic polynomial means like the example can be written like this, 2x² plus 5x plus 6. Okay, the highest power of the variable is what? 2. So it will be known as quadratic polynomial. Cubic polynomial, now you can give the examples, na? Cubic polynomial is like 3x cubed plus 5. Okay, the highest power of the variable is what? 3. Biquadratic, 4x to the power 4 minus 3x cubed. 3x² plus 5. Okay, this can be the example of biquadratic. So like this, students, the polynomials are divided. And on the basis of this topic or whatever I have taught today, okay, on the basis of this, you can solve the first exercise of your chapter number 2. 2.1 you can solve on the basis of this. So firstly, what is written, whatever it is written on the board, you can note it down. And on the basis of this, you will solve exercise 2.1, and then we will see the next topic in our next one. Okay? Thank you, everyone. Have a nice day.